I love this time of year. The winds have finally started blowing. It's like, cool. Fall is springing, finally. It's taking some time to get here, but when you live in a warm environment area like Sacramento or California or someplace where there's a lot of sun like high desert, you know, sometimes you enjoy when the clouds finally come and you can see the big puffballs, you know, of a thunderhead, or you see the cirrus cumulus, the nimbus, or all the different varieties of ways that the clouds come carried on the gift of the breeze that bring them along, or the jet stream that shoves them all across the nation, whether the highs or the lows. It's always interesting to see what God can do at different times of the seasons, how he chooses to bring the light in different ways and variety that give to us the brightness of his presence as we seek him daily, to walk with him, to be fellowshipping with him, to know him as he is in the light, as we are in the light. To know and to have oneness with God is to walk in the light as he is in the light, so we would have fellowship one with another as well as with him. And I enjoy that. I employ that in my life. I expect to meet God in the light and the brightness of his countenance. For so I look at each and every day as walking and talking with God every day. And in a simple way, I do that with daily light. I look at this devotional and I say, oh, it's only the Word of God. It's only the Bible. It's only his Word that is being recorded in topics, but without putting a topic in. It's just simply put there for the morning and the evening throughout the year. And I say, ooh, that's interesting. And so I enjoy what I employ to be a part of my day. I involve myself in daily light as God gives me light into what his word would say and how he would talk to me today. Maybe you'll do the same with you. Maybe not. You see, it's according to his will and his pleasure that he chooses to reveal to you what he would say this day, as opposed to what I may say, or how I may interpret, but it's God who chooses to apply to you his word, as only he can do, because I most certainly have no idea what you may be going through, but I do know what I have to do, and that is to participate with listening, seeking, hearing, reading, and adjusting myself according to the light that I've been doing. Moses wist not that the skin of his face shone while he talked with him. Not unto us, O Lord, not unto us, but unto thy name give glory. Lord, when saw we that you were hungry and we fed you, or thirsty and we gave you to drink? In lowliness of mind, let each esteem each other better than themselves. Be clothed with humility. Jesus was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun, and his raiment was white as the light. All that sat in the council, looking steadfastly upon Stephen, saw his face as it had been the face of an angel. The glory which thou hast given me, I have given them. We all, with open face beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as the Spirit of the Lord. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it gives light unto all that are in the house. You know, I love this time of year, because thinking of light and thinking of his word, I get a joy out of setting out throughout my house certain places where I have candles, or certain places where I have subdued lighting. Sometimes I even use indirect lighting. I use it as refractions and reflections off of walls that reflect the light and give even more luminescence to a certain area, and it causes me to feel a certain way, to be in a certain mood, to think of God in a different way. And so sometimes I like candlelight. Sometimes I like moonlight. Sometimes I like the morning streaming in through my sliding glass door, and I see God waking me up for the day that is dawning. And I have mirrors that catch that light and reflect it back into the room. And it's beautiful to see how it takes my living room and makes it into a wonderful cathedral, as it were, of God waking me up in my day. Maybe you don't have that kind of light, but you can always choose to be in the light as He is in the light, walking in His Word, choosing, as it were, your own devotional, like daily life, to walk and to talk and to fellowship with God in a personal, intimate way. For me, I look at everything in my day and I say, oh, Lord, are you there? God, are you speaking? Ooh, look at that. Isn't it marvelous what God has done? Look at this glorious sight that God has created for me in this plant that, yea, though I purchased it, would not have blossomed the way it has had it not been for God and I working together to cause it to bloom and to be that which God wanted me to see, which was something that blossomed with the right amount of water, the right amount of soil, the right amount of light, the right amount of temperature, the right amount of vitamins, so to speak, for the soil that it's in. And God has blessed me in seeing that in you, in me, in people around me, in the things that I do, in the way that I conduct my life, in the way that I choose to observe and to do the things God tells me to do. I remember the days of old, but I look forward to the days to come. And I observe today to do that which God has made real to me in the day that I hear Him and see Him and walk with Him today. For only today am I able to know God in a personal and intimate way. So today, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart, as it says, a provocation, obviously, because if you do, a hardened heart is not a tender heart. And I would rather that I carry my heart on a sleeve and have it hurt than to be a stony heart and have God remove it and cast it to the ground to be shattered in a thousand pieces. I don't know about you. I only know me. And I know I need all the help I can get. So when I do, I choose to read, to walk, and to live by not the Word, but the light that God gives me through His Word. May it be so too with you, that you choose to walk in the light of His countenance as He leads you by His light. For Jesus said, I am the light of the world.